Hi, welcome to Dolcera. Dolcera is an intellectual property and market research services company. We provide comprehensive landscape reports in technology and market areas of interest to our clients. This video will showcase a business research report on OLED. Here we go with the summary of the report. The report covers the technological background of OLED. Also, we analyze the OLED-based mobile phone industry in terms of products, applications, market size and structure, competitive environment and technology, and determine its future prospects. It also covers the cluster analysis performed on the various segments of mobiles available in the market today and determines the segments which are likely to move to OLED-based mobile phones. We also apply Bass diffusion model to forecast sales of OLED display-based mobile phones. The twofold objective with which we set out doing this research were 1. To estimate the market potential for OLED mobile phones. 2. To forecast the adoption rate of OLED mobile phones. The following methodology was employed for this analysis. First, the technological overview to set the context for the study. Second, the cluster analysis of TFT display mobile phones in the present market to identify potential market segment for the OLED technology. Third, Bass diffusion model to predict the adoption rate of OLED mobiles by using historical sales data of suitable analogous products as proxies. OLED technology overview. An OLED typically has a 5-layer construction on a single layer of organic material. Types of OLED: passive matrix, active matrix, transparent, top emitting, foldable and white. Kindly note that we have segmented high-end phones unlike popular research report vendors who classify a smartphone simply as a phone with an operating system. Here are some possible applications of OLED. Some of these have already been prototyped and extensive research and development on various applications is in progress as we speak. Some of the key players in the OLED mobile phone category. As you can see here, the source for the information has been hyperlinked. We have mentioned here the advantages and disadvantages of the OLED technology. The second part of our research is the cluster analysis. The business definition of cluster analysis states that it is a class of statistical techniques that can be applied to data that exhibit natural groupings or making groupings in a fashion such that objects from the same cluster are more similar to each other than objects from different clusters. In our case, the purpose was to identify the appropriate cluster for launching the AMOLED mobile phones under the smartphone category. Also, we were keen to understand the current positioning of the leading smartphones by their manufacturing company. The clustering method involves an algorithm that aims to minimize within cluster variance and maximize the variability between clusters. The samples used for clustering were divided into two groups, one consisting of candy bar design and the other with clamshell or slider designs, with the thickness being the differentiating parameter. Consequently, we boiled down to 5 clusters in candy bar design and 4 clusters in clamshell or slider designs. The parameters considered for defining the clusters include camera quality in megapixels, input method, that is conventional keypad or QWERTY keyboard or touch screen, the display size, the wireless LAN feature, the color and resolution, thickness of the phone, and finally the price. As mentioned, the key factors identified were chosen on the rationale that input and display sizes are related to the viewing aspect. And since these high-end mobile phones were highly priced, the consumer or the end user is not expected to be price sensitive. This link here will provide you with the detailed information on our cluster analysis of the TFT display mobile phones. The Wikipedia definition of Bass diffusion model states, it's a model that describes the process of how new products get adopted as an interaction between users and potential users. It has been described as one of the most famous empirical generalizations in marketing. The model is widely used in forecasting, especially product forecasting and technology forecasting. Rightly, we have made use of the Bass diffusion model for two different extrapolations to determine the sales data for the future OLED mobiles. We studied the sales behavior of proxy analogous products, namely iPhones and LCD monitors. Just to take note of some of the terms used in this model, N being the total or cumulative number of customers who have already adopted the new product through time period T. NT-1, total number of customers for the previous time period. S being the number of new adopters, essentially the difference between NT and NT minus 1. Further, the key parameters used here are as follows. M being the total market size, P being the coefficient of innovation, which represents the probability that an innovator will adopt the product at time T. Q being the coefficient of imitation, which is nothing but the probability that the imitator will adopt the product at time T, which is usually the result of word of mouth or social contagion that result from interpersonal communications between adopters and non-adopters. Now, some fundamental formulae and equations that have been used. Here are the proxy analogous products considered and the relevant data. Proxies used were LCD TV, plasma display TV and LCD monitor with a weighted average of their respective sales figures. The detailed calculations can be accessed through the links provided. As you can see here, this is the extrapolated graph with the sales figures of the future OLED based mobile phones. You may notice that the initial years, that is 2009 and 2010, OLED mobile phone market will grow at a slow pace because the initial sales will be mainly caused by innovators. From 2011 to 2015, market will grow at a very fast pace because of the large number of imitators started buying the product at this time. Sales will be driven by these early adopters. In 2016 and 2017, market will grow at relatively slow rate. Sales will be mainly caused by late adopters. 2018 onwards, growth is very less. Sales will be caused by laggards. Also, the market approaches its saturation point. From 2016, there is a dip in the sales, so there could be a substitute superior technology by that time. This graph shows the trend of adoption by the innovators and the imitators of the OLED-based mobile phones. Even this graph has been plotted with the extrapolated data from the analogous products data. From this graph, we can see that the model is dominated by imitators than innovators. OLED mobile phones will get off to a slow start in first 2 years. However, once a critical mass is reached by the second year, strong imitative effects will take over and the buyers now would be imitators rather than innovators. To fortify our results, we further validated the extrapolated data from the LCD proxy analogous product by choosing yet another proxy analogous product, that is the iPhone. Here you can see similar analysis and graphs as the previous case. We have placed both the graphs adjacent to each other to confirm that our forecast for OLED based mobile phones based on the analogous products was good. Further, we have listed the market drivers and constraints for the OLED adoption. Here, we give you a sneak peek of the smartphones employing the new OLED technology. For more information and for similar services, please do get in touch with us. Thank you.